Welcome to the second chapter in the TI Precision Lab series on brushed DC motors. My name is Hector Hernandez, and this chapter's objective is to explain what an H-bridge is, how it is made, what are its components, and how to drive a brushed DC motor with it. The H-bridge is an electronic circuit that looks like the letter H. An H-bridge is used to drive a load, such as a brushed DC motor, in both directions, and it controls the flow of current to a load. Components typically found in an H-bridge circuit are a voltage supply and the ground, diodes, which are utilized for current recirculation and current decay. These diodes are typically the body diodes of the FETs. A load, such as a brushed DC motor. And four switches, such as transistors. The most common transistor found in an H-bridge is a MOSFET. MOSFETs are used more than bipolar junction transistors due to their thermal capabilities and their efficiency. N-MOSFETs are more common than P-MOSFETs because P-MOSFETs require a larger area for the same current carrying capability. The drawback of N-MOSFETs is that the gate needs to be driven 5 to 10 volts higher than the source to turn on the high side FET. This means that the high side FET requires a charge pump or bootstrap circuit to turn on. Motor drivers integrate this charge pump or bootstrap. In this presentation, the FETs are not integrated within the motor driver. Some motor drivers integrate the FETs. The FETs can be turned on or off with control signals. The control signals are often generated from a microcontroller, and these signals can be pulse width modulated or DC. A motor driver interprets the control signals and amplifies them to control the FETs found in the H-bridge. The FETs are turned on or off depending on the polarity of the control signal the FETs are connected to. By controlling when and what FETs are turned on or off, a flow of current to the motor can be controlled. In an H-bridge, there are multiple ways to control the flow of current through a brushed DC motor. A brushed DC motor can spin in a reverse or in a forward direction. Once the current is flowing in forward or reverse direction, the direction of the current is maintained by the inductance of the motor. When the FETs are disabled in forward or reverse direction, the direction of the current is maintained until the current decays to zero. The flow of current continues through the body diodes of the FETs that are not being driven. Those FETs are the opposite direction's FETs. If a high side or low side FET is turned on before the driven direction's FET has turned off, there can be a short period of time in which the two FETs are conducting. This period, called shoot-through, can be extremely hazardous to the FETs and to the motor driver. Shoot-through is prevented by adding dead time. Dead time is a period when all FETs are turned off. Dead time is inserted during a direction change after disabling forward or reverse direction FETs and before turning on the other direction's FETs. As an example, drive the motor in reverse direction, then insert the dead time by turning off the reverse direction's FETs. You can turn on the forward direction's FETs to change the direction. To go back to reverse direction, insert the dead time between the direction change. Another method to regulate the flow of current is called fast decay. In fast decay, the current decays towards zero faster than other decay methods such as slow decay. This method is also called coast since the motor coasts instead of brakes to a stop. This behavior is due to the motor speed being proportional to the voltage across the motor, and the voltage decreases at a slower pace while the current decays faster. During fast decay, current will decay quickly because a voltage of greater magnitude but opposing polarity is applied to the driven inductive load. There are two kinds of fast decay, asynchronous and synchronous decay. When diodes are used in the path that the current decays, this decay is referred to as asynchronous decay. As an example, drive the motor in forward direction, then insert the asynchronous decay to decay the current. The same decay method can be achieved in reverse direction. On the other hand, synchronous decay is when the FET on resistance is in the path of the current decay instead of the body diode. It is often more efficient to utilize the FET on resistance as a safe path for current decay instead of the FET body diode. Before using synchronous decay, dead time is utilized to prevent a shoot-through condition since the opposite direction's FET will be turning on. As an example, drive the motor in forward direction, then insert the dead time, and then start the synchronous decay. The same decay method can be achieved in reverse direction. For more information on brushed DC motors and TI brushed DC motor drivers, please visit the brushed DC motor driver page on TI.com.